Two.
Hi, how are you? Full house, great, great, lovely to see you. Welcome to the Bell Table. We're in for a real treat this Friday night of the Jazz Festival weekend, and I can remind you that limerickjazzfestival.com, the website, has plenty of information, details, things coming up over the coming days. So you've had the fire alarm, have you? Don't forget the mobile phones, okay? Mine's going off now. And very welcome. We're in for a real treat, as I said. It's a jazz ensemble tonight. As you can see behind me, there's a string ensemble as well. So it'll be plenty of lush arrangements. I'm familiar with the album myself. It's an album called Making Other Arrangements, the current release by Linley Hamilton, a man who's no stranger to Limerick audiences. Linley, a trumpeter, but also a regular presenter of jazz programs on BBC Radio Ulster. And I'm going to keep this brief because Linley is a man well able to talk himself. So we've got the musical director for this particular session and the man who did the arrangements for the album, Cian Boylan. And Cian was telling me this is more or less the lineup that they had on the album with a couple of extra string players. So making other arrangements, a couple of sets coming up tonight. There'll be a break in between, as per usual here. And during the intermission, there'll be an opportunity for you to purchase copies of the spanking new CD. So without further ado, Linley and Cian, thanks.
Suspend everybody out tonight because I want the musicians to do the talking. This is a lifetime ambition for most horn players to stand in front of an orchestra or an ensemble of this nature. Every single one of them a household name. Everybody that, whenever you're listening in the house with your gin and tonic, I think that's a drink of choice these days, isn't it? You're sitting listening to a fabulous record and you hear the strings, and I think I must look down the names. And if you bothered to do that, then you'd find these guys on the record. These are the best string players in Ireland, and it's been an incredible project to have them involved. And the thing that emanates the whole way through this project is one word. It's not necessarily jazz, it's not even music, it's not even communication. And those are the three things, probably the most important thing for me in my life, apart from my donkeys. It's love. Ken and I love each other. It's true. Ken and I love each other. It's that kind of incredible feeling. For anybody who knows John Daly, you'll know that everybody loves John Daly. It's John Daly. Yeah. John Daly is what we affectionately refer to in the business as the man. And it's a surreal honour to be here at his festival and this fabulous city where my brother went to university 30 years ago and rowed as part of the Limerick rowing team, and I used to come down and cheer him on. And it's lovely to be back again. I've been here a few times. But this wonderful orchestra, and the man who made the sounds possible, the man who had the vision to translate my head and heart onto a page for these people to engage with you tonight, is Keane Boyle. This is another big belter. This is Here's to Life.
Thank you.
from the band in Garland and the saxophone. Hopefully you'll tweak that melodies are really important thing in this record. Of course, that means the space, and that's why all these amazing things are able to happen. And that's because it's key in making it happen. And we're just sort of pawns and piece to bring the fabric together. But the important things are the songs. And I think the thing that we have as a definition in terms of what instrumentalists and what musicians are, instrumentalists, the people who use the tunes to demonstrate their incredible capacity to play. The musicians are people who leave that stuff behind because the song might not require it. And that's why these guys are in the band tonight. So the tunes and the songs are really important. The songs with lyrics sometimes mean even more than the melodies of that. This is one by the great singer-songwriter James Taylor called Don't Let Me Be Lonely.
Thank you.
One of the Camden festivals, not just the good ones, but the ones that we really, really love, and this combines both things here at Limerick. So. But the other thing you probably realise as well is that to arrange love on a page, you have to be a lover. And of course, Cian is a lover. He wrote this one for his love. This is Deborah's theme.
King. King.
Okay, this is one of those ones we have to put on the record, definitely, because I've always been associated with jazz, so we've thought we'd have a good one of those. I'll be affectionately referred to as a brutal one. It's a toughie. And we first lost to take the servers, and we lost. But that's all right. It's a Dizzy Gillespie tune called Con Alma. And for those of you who know it, you know it's one of those beautiful tunes that is really nice. It's beautiful.
Thank you.
and Fiona. I've been a player for a long, long time. So I should say a couple of dog songs, just in case the truth does come out. No, I meant that big time. One of the pleasures I've had of sort of doing session work over the years has been since the Commitments movie came out, now I was about 20, it never came out, which means you probably were about old-ish. They've had various singers in back and vocals in the group, so I met this lady during that case, but she's actually a lead singer of an amazing band called Bark. She's a force of nature, force for good, empathetic, supportive, open-minded, and just one of those people. Sometimes we associate music with her lyrics, her attitude, her spontaneity, and the way that she just generally performs. That she is one of those purveyors of truth with the messages that sort of keeps the politicians, or tries to keep them straight, anyway. This is, ladies and gentlemen, Jessica Kavanagh.
Thank you. say it's true. Oh, that dreams can tell a thing or two. Oh, no, no. And sleep, it's the rebel sleep.
Papa, God.
Before the break, we want you to get a break because I know a lot of people said they wanted to buy the CD, and we have a very special deal tonight because it's Jazz Festival, buy one, get one, and we'd like to think you'll avail of it. But before we do this number, once again, Cian Boylan and the Camden Orchestra. Ivan Lynch's song that was made famous first time around anyway by a lady called Diane Shore, a blind pianist who's part of the GRP label whenever GRP ruled the world. I think it's split up into different things now, Sunnyside and Mac Avenue, but if you're interested in buying CDs of this kind of music, there's labels that sort of specialise in it. Anyway, this is a fabulous song called Love Dance. We're going to take a break after this, but we'll be back in 20 minutes for the second half. Thank you. Orchestra, Jessica Kavanagh, Kane Boyd of the Camden Orchestra, and Linley Hamilton. We'll see you after the break. Thank you.
Okay, welcome back. Band are nicely refreshed, I gather, so good to go. We're looking at maybe another hour. We're looking at another hour, but thereabouts, which, if my maths is correct, will give us just enough time to get upstairs to Dolan's for the late night gig tonight. Okay? So I have a long list here of names. Most of them are first name only, so I'll go by that convention. So, string section with Paula on cello. Catherine and Una on viola. Louis and Carol on violins. Adam David on violin. That's the way you wrote it, that's the way I read it. Ken Rice, orchestra leader, violin. I think that could be strings leader. Can't
it? Ken
with
that one.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. We can settle that one outside after. We've some local lads then in the rhythm section. Peter on bass. Joe in the far corner on guitar. John, we all know, of course, on the drum. And there's some stalwarts of the music business, Brendan Doyle, one of the retailers here. During the intermission, Brendan admitted he was musical director, Riverdance, version 3, yes? Amongst his many talents. And Matthew Beryl playing the reeds as well. Jessica Kavanagh will be back to sing some more vocal source as well in part 2. Which leaves us with Kian Boylan, musical director. And the band himself, Linley Hamilton, on trumpet. Thank you.
thank you very much indeed, and thanks for those of you who bought a CD at the break, and for those of you that didn't. That was Cat and Mouse, and I actually have a cat and a mouse, but that came from that never wrote. That's one that we hope is going to be on Making Other Arrangements 2. And Making Other Arrangements 1 is really what we're all about tonight. But we have booked the recording studio for the last week in August 2020, and we hope to be back here October or whatever it is, September 2021, to play the next album. Who knows? Haven't spoken to John yet, but I think if he's on the drums, he'll be happy enough. This is a song that I picked up through the radio. So I have a radio show, and what you might not know about radio shows is that the post is heavy, and these labels and managers and pushers and pluggers are sending you CDs, probably the tune of about 30 a week. And they arrive through the door and you can't help but obviously put them on and listen to them. And sometimes you just get something and you can't take it off. And I'm sure other DJs would sort of say, well, whenever I have a party, I'm going to play that one. But I just say, whenever I do an album, I'm going to record that one. And this is one now that I've recorded twice. And I think that's even more often than the guy that wrote it. It's written by Abdullah Ibrahim, who saw him playing it live in Montreal. 6 years ago, it's called Joan Cape Town Flower, and it's just become a real big part of me, and I'm going to share it with you now.
Thank you.
Pretty sure John's had it here. If he hasn't, he will next year. Because she really is unbelievable. The interpretive melody, the emotional connection. It's really funny. I don't want to talk long because I have a bad reputation for it. But we just came back to college. I'm the university lecturer in music, and we just came back to college this week, and we were having a difficulty with a student emotionally connecting with the music. So I got them to put the guitar on the chair. And we discovered that in the 10 years she'd been playing it, she'd played it about 3,500 hours. And she'd been touching it for that time. And we discovered that, of course, she'd never touched anybody else as much as her guitar. In fact, not within 1%. She'd never held anybody for 3,500 hours. Surprise, surprise. So we got the guitar around the chair and we asked it to play. And of course it didn't. And we discovered that guitars don't play, people play, and you don't play the instrument, you play what's in your head, and you have to connect with the head. So why it's important is that is because whenever Leanne Carroll sang this song the first time I heard it, that's when the penny dropped for me. So of course, Kane did the rest. We're going to play this one for you tonight. What are you doing the rest of your life?
Thank you.
guys in the band and the girls in the band might not know, of course, if they're on that record, they have a big check coming because it was played in BBC Radio 2 last week. It's always very nice. Anyway, you've heard the rest. Now we're at the best. We're going to bring back on Jessica Kavanagh.
Like.
Kian Boylan. The Camden Orchestra.
Probably doing it the wrong word, sometimes things just pop in my head. But there's a guy sitting in the band tonight, and I've known him since he was 15, and he's from a place called Morrison, which of course is the capital of jazz in Ireland. If he's from it, it is. And I can't describe the amount of respect and love that is shown to this guy, because he, I think it was 1983, he made a mistake. I think it was a split quaver. That was the last time.
He's always bring that up, don't you?
He's kind of everybody's hero, certainly in terms of brass players in Ireland. He's a reasonable artist for a career. And I have to stand beside him quite a lot, and I feel terrible because I know that I'm going to let him down somewhere along the line. A split note or something is out of tune. And he's so forgiving and so inspirational. And, you know, sometimes we take it for granted that we're playing in front of monster musicians. But this one is one I never take for granted. Please give a special round of applause for one of my all-time Irish musician heroes, Brendan Doyle. I'm for an amazing orchestra, ladies and gentlemen, aren't you? Would you just love to bring them home? You're smarter than I thought you were. Yes, that's right. CDs are still out there if you want to get them. Well, come out and sign them. And Kane's CDs are worth an awful lot more than mine because he plays with Brody Gallagher and a lot of big superstars. So you probably want to get something on the internet for that in 10 years' time. Anyway, this is our last number. So thank you so much. We're trying to finish up so we can go around and see the monster Julien Colarossi in Dublin, because of course John Daly has put this incredible jazz festival on, and it's wonderful to have the Limerick guys, the rhythm section, Kate and Joe. But there's a funny story in this one. I bought my wife a guitar 2 years ago on her birthday, thinking that it was an innocent thing to do. But she knows that I like a bass. 45 minutes to an hour, and whenever I go to the bath, she thinks, okay, well, I'll practice the guitar when he's in the bathroom, and that's after 45 minutes. So she was working on this new thing, and I was listening to it, and I said, what's that? And she says, I wrote that by myself. She was humming this tune, playing the chords, and I thought, well, I don't know about that. So I jumped out of the bath, and I got the trumpet out, and I said nothing, and I put the phone on, and I recorded it. And what did I do next? I emailed it to Kane, and it's on the album. And she can't believe it. And it's about her sister. And her sister is a young lady who hasn't had the best of luck. I'll just leave it at that. And it's hard to get her to smile sometimes. But she smiled when she heard this, when she was named after her. And whenever we got the album, we gave her a copy of the album. And she rang me, trying to keep herself together. She rang me and she said, I love all the other tunes. Mine is the best. So this is for Carmel, written by my wife Maggie, and Steve, obviously came here. I mean, everybody's been coming through with this one. So thank you so much. If you want to take us home, we're outside. Thank you.
That's it, because the weekend continues after this. Dublin's Sea Lion Fire is filmed by the Man and Drink. That's fine.